respected Professor Suresh, Professor Deepika Deka, President of Assam Pharmacy Council, sorry, I think my voice is not coming through properly. Is that okay?
Okay, sir.
Okay. So, faculties, students of Pratiksha Institute of Pharmacy, and friends, I am happy to participate in this international webinar on the management of COVID-19 pandemic. And we, in this meeting, as you have already seen, we have started discussing the facts, challenges, and future prospects. This is a pandemic which was unique, which was so sudden that it locked the whole world, not only the whole the people, but even the economies were completely locked down. So in this kind of a lockdown situation, one of the most affected batch of people, I would say, are the students, those who are in the higher education institutes. They were totally brought into a new paradigm. I mean, the whole situation of education changed. That is because the student, when in a face-to-face interaction in a college, in a college with the teacher, has a face-to-face interaction, it is a collective behavior they show there, because they have other students participating, discussions with the teacher among themselves. Whereas the COVID-19 situation brought in the student into a room between the four walls with a gadget in front, or to listen to it, which was there to interact with the outside world. So it is a situation where he had to basically interact from his own self in an individualistic way. So the whole platform of education slowly took a change to a individualistic mode of learning, rather than a collective learning process. Now, not only this, when you face a new situation, you basically land up with new emotions, new emotions, and this brought the students onto a higher degree of mental stress. And this immediately brought them into a situation where they needed to be mentally much more stronger, more resilient, and they had to face the world almost alone. So not only this, the administration in these colleges, or they had to take their own decisions in a different way. For example, in Assam, the immediate fallout was that the whole process, the academic year, basically got shifted, and In fact, the next academic year is shifted by 3 months. Not only that, it brought in another way of taking the students forward into the next year by closing this year in a formal way. Now, in this situation, we are talking of the students to be evaluated in a much more difficult way, I would say, in a state like in Assam, because here the online mode of education is not being used, or it cannot be used by all the students who are in the far-flung interior places where they are residing right now. So one has to find out a hybrid way of holding or taking them forward into the next year of their academic career. So these are some of the difficulties which people have faced, but at the same time, there have been positive ways in which people have started gaining knowledge in many different areas. As you already heard from Professor Suresh, he was talking about those who were not very conversant with the digital world had to come in. They were forced to basically take help of the digital gadgets to reach out to their students, to their fellow beings. So it has given us definitely knowledge in some areas which we otherwise would not have probably learned. Now, this is again a situation in which we are holding today's international webinar rather than a seminar. This is something which has brought many people closer to the realities of technology, which is coming up in the world. Now, not only this, it has, I would say, most significant way this COVID-19 has positively affected us is when we look at the environment around us. It has become much cleaner. The pollution is degraded. Now, we know that before we came into COVID-19 situations, there were two major crises in front of us. One was the pollution we are fighting against, and the energy crisis, which was not allowing the developing countries to go very fast at times, simply because of the not so clean energy we have been using, or we are used to use. This should go on, because we would like to have a cleaner environment around us for the benefit of everybody, for the benefit of our next generation. So in that case, how could we do it? If we go back, once we come out of COVID-19, if we go back to the practices, what we had been doing earlier, will definitely bring us back slowly into the same situation once again. So can we try to change our habits in such a way that we do progress, at the same time try to keep the pollution or the environment around us free, clean? It's really wonderful to hear or read in the newspaper that people in Siliguri can see the Kanchenjunga up there, clean, beautiful blue sky. Delhi has a much bluer, cleaner environment now. So these are issues which we, the technical people, have to look for. How could we continue? How could we make it sustainable for us to have a cleaner environment around us? So this is one of the biggest advantages we have seen by, we were forced to basically get into this habit. Now, coming back into the into our future learning, I would say that immediately we need to take, especially in Assam, we have to find out a way to take our students to the next year in a way which all our students can use. So I would say that although we are using the online methods for giving them all the lessons which we wanted to, they are learning, but somehow when it comes to taking an examination, we will not be able probably to take them through online mode because not everybody has an access to a gadget which will allow him to download his question paper, write the answer, and upload it back. So this is a difficulty, in fact, students are facing even in Delhi University. So let alone the universities in the Northeast. Therefore, we need to have ideas of holding face-to-face examination, probably in a staggered manner, or in batches, starting with the final year students whom you would like to graduate out and jump into the society or be entrepreneurs, get into jobs, because some of them have already got good offers from different areas who will be able to join these, provided they complete their education. Therefore, we need to have them in a, we need to look at it in a positive manner and have a face-to-face examination, probably keeping in mind the social distancing, which we must have. Therefore, we may have to have them in batches. Therefore, we may have to provide them with slightly different question papers, give options, and then give them the chance to go ahead to the future. Now, when we come out, the higher education institutes needs to think and imagine in future of education through collaboration. Rather than cooperation, I would say we should talk of collaboration. There have been good examples during COVID-19 also. Just to give you an example, I read about the mechatronic engineering department in Yangon Technological University and Mandalay Technological University in Myanmar. They combined together, put their strong points together to develop a robot which could help us in this COVID-19 time to use these robots to deliver various food or medicine to the patients. And that is right in the front end of this war. They have been able to help us. So similarly, if we think of joining hands between institutes, even in our country, we could definitely come up with different gadgets to help us in this war and in future as well. I think it is really commanding that we did not produce PPE kits at all 2 months back, whereas today we are the second largest producer of PPE in the world. So there are positive ways of looking at this short period, which we find little difficult to live in. We once we have a new new life beyond COVID-19, we need to think of ways of bringing in collaborations in such a way that we have technologies helping us to retain some of the advantages which we gained during this period. We need to have this concept of emergency loans to the needy students, actually, which we must introduce when we come in with the help of the government and with the universities. Introduction of research funds would definitely help us looking into very many different areas of research, which we were probably not doing earlier. But I would say that I must say that by going digital, we have helped in the university area in a big way. Just to give an example, the Calcutta University was to basically digitize all the documents what they had, finally was done. This collection of literature was digitized and it was made open to the to all the universities so that everybody could access it, everybody could read. So this is a very, very positive contribution. I would say that in the coherent relationship among the universities. So funding different collaborative activities among the institutes, among the universities would bring us to very close to a situation where you will have online education at the same time collaborations to do many activities which will take us towards the so-called practical examinations. Now, in an online mode, it is very difficult to have that part of our technical education, but that could be done through collaboration where one could collaborate with others to do this part of the activities with the help of another university for, let's say, an online university completely. So it is definitely a positive note that we have been able to take the online education to in the right spirit and propagate it as much as possible. However, we should not forget that we have a section of students who cannot basically at this moment directly contribute into this kind of mode of education, but we could definitely help them to come up, and then slowly we could then bring in online education along with the face-to-face interactions in a very normal way. I must here, I would like to give an example. About 30 years back, there was a very big earthquake in Mexico, and that forced them to go in for online education to get connected to the students in the interior areas. And they, in fact, took this platform of Zoom, and then somehow after that, they continued with it in such a way that now when the necessity came during COVID-19, within a week, they were able to bring back their normal education through online mode, just because they had this platform already existing. So they did not forget 30 years back that we may need it later, therefore let's hang on to it, which is not the way we do things probably in India. So I would suggest that we do keep this habit on and then continue with this online mode of education along with face-to-face education. So once we come out of COVID-19, we will have to live with the virus for some time at least, till we find a solution to take care of this COVID-19. And in this kind of a situation, I think most important role that can be played by the pharmacist who can actually take propagate the knowledge of using hygienic methods or even medicines in the right way, and where they could directly play a more interactive role with the people than what they are playing right now. Right now, probably they are helping the medical personnels to a great part, but in the time to come after we come out of this pandemic situation, I think the pharmacist will have to play a more aggressive, more direct role to the society. With this, I would once again like to thank Pratiksha Institute for allowing me to talk to students who are not in my domain of teaching, I would say, which is technology, hardcore technology. But I'm happy to interact with them because they are a part of our university, who are really helping the society to fight this war against the virus which we are experiencing at this moment. So I wish them once again all the best for during this international webinar, and let us hope that this will bring our society up in their understanding of this pandemic situation around us. So with this, I would like to end and thank you once again.